Hello kids! A blessed Saturday to you all! Kayo ay nakatutok ngayon sa COG Kids TV. Did you hear our theme song earlier during the countdown? Na LSS o last song syndrome din ba kayo tulad ni teacher? Let us know in the comments below. Speaking of music, are you ready to sing and dance for the Lord? Kung oo, then stand up and dance with us!
I will not fear. I know the storms will come. I know I'm not alone. You are my strength, so I will say, you make me brave. You give me courage. I won't be afraid. I won't even worry. 'Cause you've got the whole world in your hands. You fight for me. You help me stand. You make me
Teacher Grace, and you're watching COG Kids TV. Nag-enjoy ba kayo sa ating praise and worship kasama ni Teacher Jenny? If so, bigyan nga natin si Lord ng 5 big claps! In 3, 2, 1! Very good! Are you excited to learn our new character trait for today? Come in, kids! Pero apart from our COG Kids TV episodes, sana ay nakasama rin kayo sa ating COG Kids TV Zoom class last week. Yes, kids! We have Zoom classes every Saturday. Kaya kung na-miss mo na si na teacher at ang inyong Sunday school classmates, ito na ang chance mo na makasama ulit sila even behind the screen. Don't forget to join us at our COG Kids Zoom class every Saturday after every COG Kids TV episode. Do you remember our lesson last time, kids? Very good! Our topic was about contentment. We hope na marami kayong natutunan last week at sana ay na-share niyo din ang learnings niyo to your friends and family. Today, we will learn about a new character trait called courage. May idea ba kayo, kids, kung ano ang ibig sabihin ng salitang ito? I-type mo na yan sa comment section below. Pero kung hindi naman, don't worry because today, we will learn what the Bible says about being courageous. Pero bago tayo magsimula, mag-pray muna tayo. Let us do the prayer formation. First, put your hands together. Second, bow down your head. And third, close your eyes. Lord, thank you for the wonderful day that you have given us, Lord. Lord, today, as we learn your word, please help us to understand. Open our eyes, our ears, our minds, O God, and our hearts. Lord, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now let us all listen to Teacher Desiree for her Bible story.
Hello kids! Ako nga pala si Teacher Desiree. Thank you for joining us today here on COG Kids TV. We hope you're excited for another character trait na pag-aaralan natin. Today, we will learn about courage. Sabay-sabay nga nating sabihin in 3, 2, 1. Courage! Very good! Sino sa inyo kids ang nakakita na ng giant o higante sa totoong buhay? Taas nga ang kamay ng nakakita na ng giant? Alam nyo ba na hindi lang sa fairy tale makikita ang mga higante, kundi pati na rin sa Bible? Yes kids, a long long time ago, meron talagang mga giants na doble o triple ang taas kesa kay teacher. Hindi man sila makikita sa panahon natin ngayon, meron pa ring iba't ibang klase ng giants sa buhay natin. Tulad ng mga bullies, fears, and even our problems. Kayo kids, ano ang giants ninyo sa inyong life? For our Bible story today, malalaman natin ang kwento ng isang lalaki na nagawang tumalo at magpatumba ng isang totoong higante. Kayo kids, kaya nyo bang humarap at tumalo ng isang giant on your own? Well, nagawa ito ng ating bida ngayong araw, not on his own, but with God and the gift of courage. Courage o tapang in Tagalog is strength of heart and mind that helps us face danger or trouble without fear. Ibig sabihin, ang tapang ay ang lakas ng puso at isipan na tumutulong sa ating harapin ang mga panganib ng walang takot. Our Bible story for today is from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17 entitled David and Goliath. Sino sila at paano kaya nagpakita ng courage si David laban sa giant na si Goliath? Let's begin! David was the son of an Ephrathite named Jesse, who was from Bethlehem. Si Jesse ay may 8 anak na lalaki, at si David ang bunso sa kanila. 3 of David's oldest brothers followed King Saul to the war against the Philistines. At dahil dito, sobrang nag-aalala ang kanilang mga magulang, lalong-lalo na si David. As he lay on the soft green grass with sheep surrounding him and the cool wind blowing over him, David wondered why people had to fight and kill each other. Naaalala niya kung paano niya pinatay ng mag-isa ang mga lions and bears na umaatake sa mga alaga niyang sheep. Hindi niya ginustong patayin ito, pero kinakailangan. Unlike the Philistines na dumayo pa sa kanilang lugar para gumawa ng gulo. David then heard his father call his name and ask him to send food to his brothers in camp. Kinabukasan, gumising siya ng maaga at dinala ang mga pagkain sa kanyang mga kapatid. His brother Eliab told him angrily, "I know your pride and the naughtiness of your heart, you have come down so you can see the battle. Kayo kids, sino sa inyo ang bunso sa family? Sino naman ang eldest? Bilang eldest sa magkakapatid, hindi natuwa si Ilyab na pumunta ang bunso nilang si David sa giyera. Dahil alam niya na gusto lamang nitong makita ang laban. Would you have the courage to see a battle in person like David? Let's continue. Someone then shouted, "Look! There he comes!" David looked, and to his amazement, he saw a giant! At least 9 feet tall, wearing a huge brass helmet, a brass coat of mail, and a brass armor on his legs. Tinanong ni David ang kanyang kasama kung sino ang higante. Siya si Goliath of Gad, sabi ng ibang tumatakbo palayo. David wondered why people began running away and said, "Why doesn't somebody stand up to fight this giant?" Narinig ni King Saul ang tungkol dito, kaya pinatawag si David. David then told the king, "Let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight this Philistine." Then the king told him that he was too young to go and fight. David said, "The Lord delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear. He will deliver me out of the hand of the Philistine." Nang makumbinsi si King Saul, he told David he can fight Goliath and gave him a suit of his own armor. But the armor was too big at hindi nagkasya kay David. Kaya naman, nagdesisyon siyang tanggalin na lamang ang mga ito. While he walked down the brook in the valley with a staff in his hand, David chose 5 smooth stones and put them in his bag. As David drew nearer, Goliath came very angry and said, "Am I a dog that you come to me with sticks? Come to me and I will give your flesh to the birds of the air and the beasts of the field." And without fear, David replied, "You come to me with sword and with spear and with a shield, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied." Grabe kids! With God by his side, David was full of courage to face the giant Goliath. He also told Goliath na hindi siya ililigtas ng sword at spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and God himself will bring Goliath into his hands. Ano kaya ang naging reaksyon ni Goliath? Ituloy natin. Napuno ng galit si Goliath at sumugod kay David with his spear in his hands. Hindi natakot si David. Instead, he took one of his stones from his bag, put it in his sling, and threw it towards Goliath. Suddenly, Goliath stopped, stumbled, and fell. Psh! Tumama ang bato sa kanyang noo na walang protection. David then ran towards Goliath's body, took his sword, and cut off his head. Dahil sa takot, tumakbo papalayo ang mga Philistines, and the Israelites chased them back to their country. What a powerful story about courage, right kids? David did not have any physical strength na kayang tapatan ang laki at taas ng kalaban niyang higante. But his courage came from the Lord. It was bigger and greater than Goliath the giant himself. Just like David, we can also have courage if we allow God to be by our side. If you trust in Him, you can defeat any giants in your life, maliit man o kasing laki ni Goliath. Our memory verse today is from 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 47. "For the battle is the Lord's." Sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo ang ating Bible verse for today in 3, 2, 1. For the battle is the Lord's. Very good! And now for our topic today on courage, remember the word WIN. W-I-N. WIN. First, we are courageous not because we are physically strong. People think courage comes from within. But as Christians, alam natin na ang tapang ay nanggagaling from God alone. Second, if you trust God, He will help you defeat any giant. Let us remember to always put God at the forefront and let Him win the battle for you. And last, no matter how big your giant is, God is far bigger. Gaano man kalaki, kataas, o kaimposibleng matalo ang giants in your life, remember that God is the biggest, strongest, and most powerful of all. At walang higanteng hindi niya kayang talunin. And that's the end of our lesson, kids. We pray that from now on, you will have the courage when faced with the giants in your life. And now, here is Teacher Grace for our closing prayer. Kita kits ulit tayo next week. Bye!
Thanks, Teacher Desiree, for teaching us about courage. We hope you learned a lot today, kids. Ano ang favorite part ninyo sa story natin today? For me, I love the part where David courageously talked to King Saul and volunteered to fight the giant Goliath. For our lesson today on being courageous, remember the word WIN. W-I-N. First, we are courageous not because we are physically strong. Second, if you trust God, He will help you defeat any giant. And last, no matter how big your giant is, God is far bigger. Remember our memory verse for today from 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 47. For the battle is the Lord's. Kids, sabayan nyo nga ako. 1 Samuel 17, verse 47. For the battle is the Lord's. Thank you, kids. And now, let us pray and do the prayer formation. God, thank you for teaching us to be courageous. Thank you for reminding us that our strength comes from you alone. Lord, today, we accept you as our Lord and Savior. Lord, please forgive us for all our sins. Lord, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you enjoyed our Bible story for today, i-share nyo na ang ating video sa inyong friends, classmates, and family. Did you miss your teachers and classmates in Sunday school? Kung oo, don't forget to join our COG Kids Zoom class every Saturday after every COG Kids TV episode and learn about God's Word in a fun and creative way. This online class is open to children age 4 to 11 years old. So don't miss it, kids. Click the Zoom link now to enter the virtual classroom. Makikita ninyo ito sa ating caption or sa comment section. Prepare yourself because we will learn more about the Lord today. Magkita-kita ulit tayo next week for another Bible story. Sabay-sabay tayong matututo sa mga kwento mula sa Biblia. Dito lang sa COG Kids TV. Bye-bye!